عارف ان يعني منال ما كانتش زعلانه ان احنا اخرنا بدايه التوك، لانها فيري انترستد في التوك بتاع الدكتور سالم، بس عشان نلحق الصلاه يعني احنا
لا
كده
هو
قاعدين
الحقيقة
في المنتصف.
انا فعلا استفدت جدا من التوك بتاع دكتور سالم، ودي تاني مرة يمكن يعني اقابله في توك، فالحقيقة استفدت جدا. ويمكن حضراتكم لما تشوفوا دلوقتي البرزنتيشن هتلاقوا ان الموضوع مكمل لبعضه، او على الاقل فعلا الجزء الهاردوير متغطي جدا، وانا شخصيا كنت مستفيدة جدا من التوك بدكتور سالم، فبشكره جدا.
طيب تفضل يا منال، the mic is yours.
ماشي، اتفضل. اول كل سنه وحضراتكم طيبين. انا في الحقيقه يعني بتشرف جدا اني اشارك النهارده في الورلد كوانتم داي ان ايجيبت، وهتكلم عن الكوانتم كريبتوغرافي بروتوكولز. في البدايه هتكلم عن انترودكشن بسيطه عن الكوانتم كريبتوغرافي، وبعدها هبتدي اتكلم عن بروبوزد كوانتم كي ديستريبيوشن بروتوكول، زين برضو بروبوزد كوانتم بيت كوميتمنت بروتوكول. في البداية، what is cryptography? Cryptography is a process of encrypting and protecting data. Quantum cryptography is originally inspired by the physical concepts associated with quantum mechanics. It uses the properties of photons, which are the smallest discrete amount of quantum electromagnetic radiation and the basic unit of light. Quantum cryptography uses the concepts of quantum mechanics as the uncertainty principle, no cloning theorem, and the quantum entanglement. There are many quantum cryptography protocols as quantum bit commitment and the quantum key distribution. Quantum bit commitment provides security over distrustful parties, like in the quantum key distribution. Enables a secure exchange of cryptographic keys between two parties through an unsecured channel. دلوقتي انا هتكلم عن الـ main stages of the quantum key distribution protocol in general. Quantum key distribution allows exchanging cryptographic keys between two parties named Alice and Bob. The two parties trust each other, but they have access to an unsecured communication channel in addition to a classical channel. Eavesdroppers usually try to observe or detect information about the transmitted photons that would change the photon state. The eavesdropper can guess the basis in a random manner. And if the guessing is wrong, Eve will lose control over the communication channel. So Eve can access both channels, classical and quantum. Quantum key distribution started from the quantum communication channel, where the preparation and measurement of qubits take place randomly in different bases. This step is followed by data sifting, where incompatible measurements are discarded from the raw key during the key sifting step. In the parameter estimation stage, Alice and Bob estimate the security parameters of the quantum communication channel in order to statistically predict the information about their key that is attacked by Eve. The error rate is produced from the parameter estimation stage and is compared by a certain threshold. If the value of the error rate is greater than a threshold, then the protocol is aborted, because this indicates that there is an attack or channel noise. In both cases, the iteration is stopped to guarantee the secrecy of the protocol. On the other hand, if the error rate is less than a certain threshold value, then the protocol continues towards the error correction stage. According to the estimation parameters, the leakage information is estimated. Then Alice and Bob have to remove the errors from their shared key to reconcile their key. This is achieved during the error correction step by implementing an appropriate classical error reconciliation algorithm. Privacy amplification is then applied to the raw key to reduce the information that Eve has gathered up about the key. In this stage, the correlation between the key and Eve is stopped, and the two parties transform their identical shared key into a new shrinked key unknowable to Eve. يعني احنا يعني انا اتكلمت بشكل عام عن الكوانتم كي ديستريبيوشن الستيبس بتاعته ان جنرال. Now we will present in concise the implementation of the BB84 protocol. يمكن دكتور سالم اتكلم باستفاضة عنه وانا هتكلم بس in concise. BB84 protocol is the first practical quantum cryptography protocol which was proposed in 1984 by Charles Bennett and the Jellis Brothers. The idea is to encode every bit of the secret key into the polarization state of a single photon that can't be measured without destroying this photon. This information will be fragile and not available to the eavesdropper. The protocol runs as follows. Alice sends a sequence of pulses, each of which contains a single photon polarized differently. Alice encodes zeros into a horizontal polarized photons and encodes ones to vertical polarized photons. This happens in half of the cases. The other half of bits chosen randomly are encoded using a diagonal polarization basis where the 45 degree polarization corresponds to zeros and the 135 degree polarization corresponds to ones. The receiver box measures the polarization using a standard setup with two detectors. Bob receives the qubits and measures each qubit in the X and Z basis randomly. These concepts of communication protocol relies on four different polarization of photon transmitted through quantum channel to carry Alice run the key of Alice in randomly. Alice assumes the use of the horizontal and the 45 degree polarizations for encoding zero and the vertical and negative 45 degree polarization to encode one. Bob randomly uses a diagonal or horizontal polarization, then looking at the result, the probability of a random result is 50%, which is the probability of using different analyzer. Alice and Bob perform comparison of their sequences so that the shared key is composed of only the compatible bits. ودي المين ايديا للبي بي 84 بروتوكول. انا مش هتكلم اكتر من كده لان دكتور سليم الحقيقه قال كل حاجه وانا استفدت شخصيا منه جدا. فدلوقتي هدخل على اور كوانتم كي ديستريبيوشن بروتوكول. احنا عملنا بروبوزد بروتوكول يعني مختلف شويه ولكن نفس الـ يعني نفس البيزكس بتاعت الكوانتم كي ديستريبيوشن. فاحنا البروبوزد بروتوكول يوتيلايزز a half duplex bidirectional quantum key quantum channel a forward and reverse in addition to a classical channel. يمكن دي تقريبا اخر كام سلايد كان دكتور بيتكلم عن الباي دايركشن كوانتم كي ديستريبيوشن بروتوكول. Alice starts the quantum key distribution protocol with two random classical bit strings s and t each of size n equal 4 plus delta n where delta is a parameter greater than zero. S comprises the bit value zero or one, while T denotes basis Z and basis X, which are denoted by zero or one respectively. N denotes the raw key bits that are encoded into quantum bits according to the values of each bit in a string S and T. SL is the Lth bit of S, and the S hat L denotes the bitwise complement of S. The effect of this procedure is that Alice encodes S as determined by T as a block of two qubit states. The classical bit zero in a string S is encoded into a state a phi node, which equals zero, zero plus one, zero. Or state phi 1, which equals 0, 1 plus 1, 1. when the value of the corresponding bit in string T is 0 or 1 respectively. But the classical bit 1 in string S is encoded into state phi node or state phi 1 when the value of the corresponding bit in string T is 0 or 1 respectively. this figure demonstrates the steps of the forward direction of the proposed protocol for one iteration, where the simulation circuit has 5 quantum registers. The first 3 qubits are under the control of Alice, while the fourth and fifth qubits are under Bob's control. Hadamard gates are used in the preparation step in order to prepare an equal superposition on the first and second qubits. UF is a quantum operator that is used for selecting the states that Alice chose to be hidden from the superposition. UF evaluated to true for the target states and false otherwise. Then the partial diffusion operator is executed for hiding quantum states from the superposition. Partial diffusion operator has the following representation that is used as a tool for increasing the security of data transmission through channels. It performs the inversion about the mean on the subspace of the system that is entangled with the third qubit in state 0, and performs a phase shift of negative 1 on the other subspace of the system that is entangled with the third qubit in state 1. Now, the 2-qubit state is ready to be teleported to Bob. In the proposed half-duplex bidirectional quantum key distribution protocol, the teleportation of 2-qubit state is a fundamental step in the forward direction and the reverse direction. In the 2-qubit teleportation protocol, Alice has 3 qubits. 2 of them represent the 2-qubit state that Alice intends to teleport to Bob, while the third qubit is entangled with Bob in a non-maximally entangled GHZ state. The classical communication channel between the two parties is used in this stage. The combined 5-qubit subsystem state can be expressed by this equation, where this part represents the 2-qubit state that Alice intends to teleport, and this part represents the non-maximally entangled state. This equation can be expanded and rewritten like this, where gamma and delta are normalized complex numbers, while A and B are real numbers. This 2-qubit teleportation scheme uses the entanglement as a quantum channel and assumes that the information of the quantum channel is known by the sender but not the receiver. This teleportation can be performed using the probabilistic quantum teleportation that can be formulated as an unambiguous state discrimination problem and drives the exact optimal positive operation valued measure operators for maximizing the probability of an ambiguous discrimination. The 4 measurements outcome are 0, 0, 0, 1, 1, 0, and 1, 1. On the other hand, Bob needs only to make a unitary operation consist of specific Pauli matrices, and so the original state can be recovered. The T operation will be applied on the subsystem depending on the value of E. Case 1, if E equal 0, 0, then the original state is recovered without applying any Pauli matrices. Case 2, if E equal 0, 1, then the phase flip gate is applied on the fourth qubit. Case 3, if E equal 1, 0, then the bit flip gate is applied on the fourth and fifth qubits. And case 4, if E equal 1, 1, then the bit flip gate is applied on the fourth and fifth qubits, and the phase flip gate is applied on the fourth qubit. So the receiver is always getting the exact state of the sender. Bob now executes the Grover quantum operator once to perform the inversion about the mean, and so recovers the states that are hidden by the partial diffusion operator. Bob then performs the predefined unitary transformation sent by Alice through the classical channel. The unitary transformation node applies the Hadamard gate H that transforms zero into the symmetric linear combination zero plus one, while it transforms one into the anti-symmetric linear transformation zero negative one. Furthermore, the unitary transformation U1 applies the symmetry effect of the phase flip gate followed by the Hadamard gate. Finally, Bob performs his measurement. ده كان بالنسبة للforward direction. أنا دلوقتي هتكلم عن الreverse direction في البروتوكول. Bob prepares a 2-qubit state based on his measurement and retransmits the qubit through the reverse direction using a symmetry 2-qubit teleportation scheme of the quantum communication channel. Alice then performs the same predefined unitary transformation sent by Alice. After repeating the protocols n steps, the sifting procedure is performed for each iteration. Alice will compare the bit and the basis values of S and T through the classical channel with Bob's measurement values after performing US in order to establish their shared row key. The security of the proposed protocol is proved against collective attack. A collective attack is those where Eve performs the same operation each iteration, but may wait to perform a measurement of Eve's private ancilla until any future point in time. We mentioned that our protocol utilizing a two-way quantum channel. In the collective attack, Eve will perform the attack operation in the forward direction and in the reverse direction. The quantum unitary operator U forward is used to attack qubits that are transmitted from Alice to Bob. And the quantum unitary operator U reverse is used to attack qubits that are returning from Bob to Alice. The following equations demonstrate the general form of the collective attack that illustrates the effect of performing the quantum operators UF, U forward and U reverse on the first transmitted qubits, where HT represents the 2D Hilbert space modeling the qubits in the transit space, and HE represents Eve's private ancilla. So U reverse and U forward act on HT tensor product HE. State E denotes the qubits prepared by Eve. State EJ denotes Eve's ancilla qubit state after the forward attack, where J denotes the index of the state. The states EIJK denotes the resulted state from the reverse attack, where I denotes the original qubit that is transmitted through the system. J denotes the index of the ancilla qubit resulted from the forward direction attack. And K represents the ancillary qubits that are entangled with the original system. دلوقتي هنشوف الاناليسز بتاع الكولكتيف اتاك ستيب باي ستيب. كل ستيب يعني هحاول اوضح الايكويشن اللي هي بتعمل لها ريبريزنت. Firstly, Alice prepares a quantum state of the form 00 plus 10. Then Eve attacks the qubit transmitted from Alice, where the unitary attack operator U forward is applied in the forward direction. The attack is performed in the first qubit. In step three, Bob performs his measurement. The probability of measuring the system in state zero is represented by this equation, while the probability of measuring the system in state one is represented by this equation. From the equations and this equation and the other one, the state after measuring the system in the basis as expected is as follows. In step four, Bob sends the predefined the prepared Bob sends the prepared to Qubit state back to Alice. Eve interrupts and applies the reverse attack unity operator, who are U reverse. In step five, Eve passes the attacked qubit state to Alice, who performs the same measurements as in the first step. The probability of measuring the system in state zero can be represented by this equation, and the probability of measuring the system in state one can be represented by this equation. By analyzing the system using the two probabilities, this equation can be obtained. After the reverse attack, Eve passes the qubit to Alice, who performs his measurement, who performs the measurement, and thus the mutual information between Eve and Bob can be achieved by tracing out Alice's system and leaving the system of Bob and Eve. احنا كده اتكلمنا عن الـ يعني الـ collective attack والـ steps بتاعته. دلوقتي هتكلم عن الـ parameter estimation stage. الـ two parties can estimate the interception of Eve in the forward and reverse direction using the parameter estimation stage. The expectation value of a probability of the quantum state can be determined from the quantity PM BA, where the parameter M denotes the encoded qubit equivalent to the bit of the message sent by Alice. And the parameters B and A represent the basis Bob and Alice used to calculate the amplitude of each state. The probability P M BA can be used to estimate this value, which is used to calculate the amplitude of each state. For example, to estimate the quantity P subscript 110, Alice initially sends the bit 1, which is encoded into qubit state 00 plus 10. If Eve's measurement value after the attack in the forward direction is 10, then the qubit state is changed to this state, where the inner product E2 E2 plus the inner product E3 E3 equal 1. Eve passes the qubit to Bob, and the probability that Bob measures the qubit in basis 1 is E3 E3 inner product. Bob transmits the qubit back to Alice, whereas Eve attacks in the reverse direction, in this case J equals 3. And so the interception changes the qubit to result this equation. Eve passes on the qubits back to Alice after the attack. This equation represents the probability that Alice measures the qubit in basis 0. The quantity P subscript MBA can be calculated using the conditional probability formula, where PR of A is the probability of the event that Alice measures A. PR of B, B is the probability of the event that Bob measures B. PR of A given B is the probability of the event that Alice measures A in the reverse direction after Bob has already measured B in the forward direction. PR of A intersection B denotes the probability that Alice measures A and Bob measures B. So P110 can be calculated, which represent one case from it. Other cases can be calculated in the same manner. This table summarizes the estimation values of probabilities when Alice initially sends 0. And this table summarizes the estimation values of probabilities when Alice initially sends 1. In all cases, Eve can't obtain any information using the ancillary particles. And if Eve wants to make the ancillary qubits distinguishable, then this attack will be detected by Alice and Bob. أنا كده اتكلمت عن الـ parameter estimation stage. هتكلم دلوقتي عن الـ error, الـ key rate. الـ key rate against collective attack can be calculated using this equation, where this part denotes the mutual information that is a measure of the correlation between two systems. It is used to quantify the amount of bets that Alice and Bob have to discard from their mutual data for error correction. This part of equation represents the mutual information between Bob and Eve that quantifies the amount of privacy amplification that is necessary to eliminate the information obtained by Eve. From the conditional channel entropy, H of A given B can be computed using this equation, where in the case that Alice and Bob estimate the error rate in the Z basis, then the probability that Alice draw P bet is zero can be computed using this equation. Now the quantity F of A given B can be computed using the combination of estimated probabilities of Alice rho P and bet and Bob's rho P bet. Then the von Neumann entropy can be computed and also can be written using the estimation probabilities computed by the two parties, Alice and Bob. If Alice transmits a bit of the message after encoding it into a two qubit, and there is no eavesdropping effect, then the qubit will be received as it is. This figure presents the measurements values when Alice transmits 0, 0 plus 1, 0 and unitary transformations u node and u one respectively, and this figure presents the measurement values when Alice transmits 0, 1 plus 1, 1 and unitary transformation U node and U1. In the case of eavesdropping interception, Eve executes the trials to measure the transmitted qubit before Bob performs his measurement, and this reduces the probability value of receiving the exact qubit state to half. The state will be changed to 0, 0, 0, 1 or 1, 0. If Alice prepares a z-basis measurement, the basis state. And if Alice prepared x basis state, then the state will be changed to be 0, 1 or 1, 1. يعني ده يعني اتكلمت عن الـ proposed protocol بطريقة مختصرة. فإحنا برضو عملنا comparison ببروتوكولز تانية. فour proposed protocol compared to other previous protocols with respect to the qubit efficiency, which is the ratio between the total number of the key bits established to the total number of qubits generated in the protocol. In the proposed protocol, in order to establish n rho key bits, Alice initially prepares n qubits in the forward direction, which is followed by using n over 2 qubits temporarily to mark the required states in performing the oracle and the partial diffusion quantum operators. The same n over 2 qubits will be used for executing the teleportation scheme, where an entanglement in GFZ state is established with Bob. In the forward direction, Bob prepares n qubits. Then after his measurement, he prepares n qubits in the reverse direction that are used in the sifting operation. The qubit efficiency for our proposed protocol is 1 over 14. Compared to other protocols, the proposed scheme does have a higher qubit efficiency ratio. يعني أنا كده اتكلمت عن الـ proposed quantum key distribution protocol. احنا برضو عملنا بروتوكول تاني اسمه quantum bit commitment. هو يمكن مختلف شوية في الـ conditions بتاعته. فهتكلم برضو باختصار عن الـ quantum bit commitment protocol. Informally, it's just like a perfectly secured version of the commitment envelope. So the general commitment schemes will have two parties, Alice, who is the transmitter, and Bob, who is the receiver. Bit commitment has two main phases. The first phase is called the commitment phase, in which Alice thinks of a message, in general a bit, Alice puts her bits inside an envelope. The second phase is called the revealing phase, in which Bob is given access to the envelope. Bob can open the envelope and uncover the secret bits that Alice put. Commitment schemes have important applications in a number of cryptographic protocols, including secure coin flipping, zero knowledge proofs, and the secure computation. But what is that يعني احنا عندنا في الكوانتم كي ديستريبيوشن كان اليس وبوب الاثنين تراستفول كل واحد، لكن كان المشكله في الايفز دروبر، في الايفز دروبر. لكن في البيت كوميتمنت عندنا حاجه ثانيه، ان اليس وبوب ديس اونست، يعني الاثنين نوت تراست ايتش اذر. سو ليتس جو اوفر ذا سكيورتي كونديشن. ليتس ستارت ويز بوب. ذا سكيورتي كونديشن فور بوب از كولد ذا بايندينج كونديشن، ويتش مينز ذات once Alice has committed the bit, she can't change its value anymore. On the other hand, the security condition for Alice is called the concealing condition. That is, Alice wants the commitment to be hidden. This means that Bob is ignorant about her bit value before the revealing phase. So the commitment scheme satisfies two conditions, the binding and concealing condition. بالنسبة للproposed protocol, our proposed protocol is used for any two classical bits at a time. The protocol starts from Alice by preparing the commitment message as a two-qubit state, followed by a two-qubit teleportation from Alice to Bob. In the revealing phase, it is the time for Bob to open the commitment message. In parallel, the commitment step, Alice and Bob prove the binding condition by comparing the message resulted from the revealing step by the message resulting from the binding step. If the values are identical, then the commitment will be accepted, else it will be rejected. The proposed protocol operates under the assumption that the two parties might cheat and also the possible existence of an eavesdropper. The protocol's structure, the quantum two-bit commitment protocol uses seven quantum registers. The first, second, third, and sixth quantum registers are under the control of Alice, while others are under the control of Bob. The commitment phase is represented by C, the revealing phase is represented by R, and the binding phase is represented by T. Hadamard gates are used in the preparation step in order to prepare an equal superposition on the first and second qubits. UF is a quantum operator that is used for selecting the states that Alice chooses to be hidden from the superposition. UF evaluates two true for the target states and false otherwise. Then the partial diffusion operator is executed for hiding quantum states from the superposition. After that, Alice applies the unitary operator UA1, which is chosen randomly by Alice from the set of unitary group to achieve the concealing condition of the protocol. At this moment, the two-qubit state is ready to be teleported to Bob. In the proposed quantum two-bit commitment protocol, the teleportation of two-qubit state is a fundamental step during the commitment phase. The teleported state can't be decoded, and hence the concealing condition is met until Alice sends to Bob the quantum operators UA1, UG, and DAB1 over the classical channel, where Bob applies the conjugate UA1. Then Bob executes the Grover quantum operator once to perform the inversion about the mean and so recover the states that are hidden by partial diffusion operator. Finally, the decoding unitary operators DAB1 are prepared by Alice for each commitment value. And so the shared classical channel, Alice sends the corresponding decoding unitary operator to Bob to restore the commitment classical two bits that Alice has committed to Bob. This table illustrates the different decoding unitary operators depending on the value of the commitment value, where Alice prepares and sends the decoding operator to Bob, who applies them during the revealing phase. The binding phase is necessary in order to enable Bob to ensure that Alice will not cheat or change the committed message after commitment. Alice and Bob chair one of the four. Alice and Bob chair one of the four Bell states. Alice prepares a secret unitary operator UA2 and applies it on the shared Bell state. Depending on the two classical bits that Alice chooses to commit to Bob, the second unitary operators are chosen. Bob chooses any combination of unitary operators and applies UB on the shared state. The binding condition is tested by executing pre-agreed decoding quantum operators between Alice and Bob. The decoding operators are inspired from the super-dense coding protocol and are applied on the shared state between the two parties. The resulting values from the binding phase is compared with the Bob's measurements. If the two outcomes are equivalent, then this proves the binding condition, and consequently, the commitment message is accepted. Otherwise, the commitment message will be rejected. Simulation, طبعاً استخدمنا الكاسكت. وبرضو يعني كل الستيبس proved mathematically in all phases were simulated using the Qiskit open source quantum development. Cat simulation circuit composed of 7 quantum registers and 7 classical registers, and it combines all the phases of the proposed protocol. In the case of the commitment of the two classical bits 00, Alice sends to Bob the DAB1 operators, which is X node, CX1 node, CX node 1, and H node. And she performs the identity gate on the shared Bell state. This histogram shows the resulting value from the binding phase, which is equivalent with the Bob's measurement, which is equal 0, 0. If the commitment is the two classical bits 0, 1, then Alice sends to Bob the DAB1 operators as X1, CX10, CX01, and X0, and applies the X gate on the shared Bell state. The resulting value from the binding phase is equivalent with Bob's measurements, which is equal 0, 1. And if the commitment is 1, 0, then Alice sends to Bob the DAB1 operators as X0, Z1, CX10, CX01, H0, and applies the Z gate on the shared Bell state. Both measurements are equivalent and equal to 1, 0. Finally, if the commitment is 1, 1, then Alice sends the X1, CX10, Z0, CX01, and X0 to Bob, and applies the X gate and Z gate to the Bell state. The measurement results from the fourth and fifth classical registers are equivalent to the measurement results in the sixth and seventh classical registers. This proves the binding condition, and consequently, the commitment message is accepted. أنا كده تقريباً يعني شرحت التو بروتوكولز بطريقة مختصرة. فالسمري إحنا دلوقتي يعني proposed the two different quantum cryptography protocols, the quantum key distribution protocols and the quantum bit commitment protocol. The quantum key distribution protocol is a half duplex bidirectional protocol. Its security is proved against collective attack by estimating the interception of any eavesdropper with high probability in both directions, where the control of the two parties under the control of the two parties, with the quantum two-bit commitment protocol, which aims to commit two classical bits at a time The achieved secured the commitment protocol consists of the commitment with revealing phases. The binding and concealing conditions have been proved. Finally, we are looking forward to include further analytical analysis to determine the exact accuracy of detecting eavesdropping. Moreover, as a future direction, enhancing the protocols against quantum channels would be an interesting research direction. بس أنا كده بشكر حضراتكم جميعا، ولو في أي أسئلة تفضلوا.
شكرا دكتورة منال. طيب لو في أي حد يا جماعة عنده أي سؤال ياريت ممكن يبعته على الشات أو يعني يرفع إيده، يعني بحيث إن إحنا نسأل دكتورة منال. لا هو أنا رافع إيدي، أنا ممكن أبقى عندي سؤال بس أنا مش عارف أرفع إيدي من عشرة وقت ما كنت بحاول يعني أتكلم دكتور سالم.
طيب أنا
في حد
ممكن
عنده
بس
أي أسئلة يا جماعة؟
ممكن حضرتك تسمح لي بس أنا في acknowledgement صغير حابة إن أنا أقوله. أنا يعني بشكر أساتذتي
قبل
كلهم طبعاً،
طب
وبخص
خلينا
بالشكر.
نوقف التسجيل عشان ولا عايزة تسجليه؟
لا عايزة أسجله بعد إذنك.
طيب اتفضلي.
أنا بحب أشكر طبعاً أساتذتي كلهم، وبحب يعني أخص بالشكر ماي بروفيسور سوبرفايزر بروفيسور دكتور أحمد يونس. أنا بصراحة بشكر حضرتك لكذا سبب. السبب الرئيسي إن أنا يعني يمكن إن حضرتك كنت سبب إن أنا دخلت في مجال الكوانتم
طيب
ده
خلينا
لما
دكتورة
درست.
منال دكتورة
معلش أنا
خلينا
أصل دي حاجة
يعني بص أنا اللي عايزة تقوليه وصل وكتر خيرك بس
لا
يعني عشان
معلش
بس
أنا
ما
بس
نخرجش
هقولها،
بره.
لأن في حاجة هتفيد بس بعض الناس. يعني اولا يعني انا على فكره يعني انا يمكن درست الكمبيوتر ساينس في كذا جامعه، في كليه الحاسبات والمعلومات جامعه قناه السويس، وكليه الحاسبات والمعلومات جامعه المنصوره، لكن انا الكوانتم دخلته لما درست في كليه العلوم جامعه اسكندريه ماده الكوانتم كومبيوتنج في تمهيد الدكتوراه. فحقيقي دي كانت اول حاجه بشكر حضرتك عليها. تاني حاجه برضو معلش اسمح لي ان انا اشكر حضرتك في مساندتك ليا يعني اداريا، لان انا برضو كنت مريت بظروف عطلتني فتره. يمكن لو حضرتك ما كنتش دعمتني اداريا ما كنتش هقدر ان انا اكمل وانشر
منال انا
واشتغل.
يعني بشكرك شكرا جزيلا على
طيب انا
الرساله
بس
ومعلش
اخر
بس
حاجه
اديني
يعني يمكن
هقاطعك
انا يمكن
بس
اخر حاجه بس هقولها، انا البيبر دي اللي هي enhancing the security of quantum communication by hiding the message in superposition، يمكن البيبر دي انا من ضمن البيبرز اللي انا كنت قريتها، وكان في جمله لفتت نظري. يعني هي الجمله دي كانت بالنسبه لي ملهمه شويه، اللي هي the proposed method اللي هي موجودة في paper is not a substitution of the above effects. It can be used together with any encryption algorithm to increase the security of the channel during data transmission. يعني الجملة دي أنا وأنا يعني بذاكر الدرس البحث ده علمت عليها، وكانت ملهمة جدا ليا، لأن أنا بعدها حقيقي يعني استخدمت الـ partial diffusion operator، فكانت النتيجة إن كان في بحثين اتنشروا. يمكن البحث الأول هو secured quantum 2-bit commitment protocol for communication system، والبحث الثاني كان secured half duplex bidirectional quantum key distribution protocol against collective attack. يمكن الحاجة المشتركة في البحثين دول كانت استخدامي للـ partial diffusion operator، وده كان من المين contribution في الـ two protocols. فأنا يعني دي حاجة بالنسبة لي كانت مهمة جدا، وكانت فعلا فرقت معايا في التو بروتوكول. آخر حاجة بس حابة أشكر مهندس كريم الصفتي على دعمه ليا برضو، لأن هو يمكن كان سبب إن أنا involved again in the science route. بشكره برضو شكرا جزيلا، وبشكر حضراتكم على حسن الاستماع.
طيب يعني أنا بشكر منال دكتورة منال شكرا جزيلا على الرسائل دي. دكتورة منال هي أحدث دكتور عندنا في الجروب، يعني لسه الدكتوراه طازة، فيعني إحنا بنشكرك وبنتمنى لك كل التوفيق، عقبال إن شاء الله يعني ما نبارك لك على الأستاذية في الكوانتم كومبيوتنج إن شاء الله يعني.
إن شاء الله يا دكتور.
طيب شكرا شكرا منال ربنا يخليك. طيب أنا بس حابب يعني أفكركم يعني إن شاء الله إحنا في عندنا بريك دلوقتي عشان صلاة الجمعة، وإن شاء الله إحنا مستمرين معاكم بعد الصلاة. مش عارف هل الشاشة ظهرت عندكم؟
تمام يا دكتور زهر.
تمام، فإن شاء الله عندنا يعني في توكس بعد الصلاة، إن شاء الله هنبدأ الساعة 1 بالظبط، إحنا دلوقتي الساعة 11 و12 دقيقة بتوقيت مصر، عشان لو حد يعني موجود خارج مصر. إن شاء الله الساعة 1 هنبدأ مع دكتور محمد زيدان بتوك بعنوان Power of Quantum Entanglement Measure in Quantum Computing Analysis and Application. دكتور محمد زيدان دكتور في جامعة جنوب الوادي في كلية حاسبات والذكاء الاصطناعي فرع الغردقة، وكمان يعني بوست دكتور فيلو ريسيرش فيلو في مدينة زويل. ثم إن شاء الله في عندنا توك، معلش أنا هصدعكم شوية بقى، هكلمكم على حاجة اسمها الأبليكيشنز أوف بارتشال نيجيشن أوبريتور أون سنجل كيوبيتس. ثم في عندنا توك يعني باشمهندس كريم، إن شاء الله كريم الصفتي، هيكلمنا على الكوانتم ماشين ليرنينج، ويعني في هاندز اون كده على الكيسكيت موديول في الكوانتم ماشين ليرنينج. وان شاء الله اخر توك معانا هتكون مع دكتور محمد سعيد، يعني هو دكتور في قسم الفيزياء عندنا في كليه علوم جامعه اسكندريه، وهيكلمنا على موضوع فيري انترستنج بالنسبه لنا اللي هو موضوع السوبر كوندكتورز، ويعني الابلكيشنز بتاعته في مجال الكوانتم كومبيوتنج، واننا عارفين ان يعني الكوانتم كمبيوتر في تكنولوجيز كتير يعني بتتنافس علشان تفوز يعني بالسباق. هنتكلم النهارده عن الكوانتم اوبتكس مع دكتور سالم، ان شاء الله نسمع عن السوبر كوندكتورز مع دكتور محمد سعيد. ويعني بشكرك شكرا جزيلا، ويعني نلتقي ان شاء الله على خير، ان شاء الله الساعه 1 الا يعني 10 دقائق او الا 5 دقائق هيكون على نفس اللينك، ان شاء الله الميتنج هيكون على نفس اللينك. وشكرا جزيلا، ونراكم على خير ان شاء الله.